Right then, YouTube, welcome back. Here we have the Tesla Model 3 Performance. We're going to do a UK first today. Well, it's going to take about 12 to 15 hours, supposedly. We're going to do the battery health check on it for the very first time. It's just hit 20,000 miles. So I'd love someone to prove me wrong, but I believe since we've only had this car for 13 months, 20,000 miles is pretty good for the performance in the UK. So I reckon this is the highest mileage performance in the UK. So we're going to run the battery health check and then obviously see what the results are. So this being the UK version, it has the LG battery pack rather than the Panasonic that all the US variants have. Believe it or not, yeah, the US one is actually slightly quicker than this one, which is absolutely crazy considering this one is fast enough for anyone on the roads. It's absolutely insane, as the name suggests. Right, the battery on this one, I don't know what stats it's gonna give us. I've never done it before, never seen one done before. So I don't know. Yeah, we'll see how it all comes out. But there's a neighbor's cat. Oh, Benji, hello. So this is a 78 kilowatt hour battery pack with a 75 kilowatt hour usable. At the moment, or since we've had the car, whenever it's on 80%, which it likes, then we see 238 miles, which is what we live with each day, which is more than enough for day-to-day stuff. If we chuck it up to 100%, it normally shows about 297 miles. So, I mean, absolutely loads, especially for a performance variant. So we're getting about 2.975 miles per 1%. So let's get on it. We'll see if it'll be interesting if the figures change at all once the battery's been recalibrated. So let's jump in on the screen then. We'll go to the service desk. Service, scroll down. Battery health. So your battery energy retention is within the expected. However, battery health, I suppose it doesn't particularly know that yet because we haven't actually run the test. That must just be from when it was last calibrated or something. The high voltage battery, like all rechargeable batteries, becomes less effective with age and use. To extend its energy retention, keep your vehicle plugged in when not in use and charged to the recommended limit. That's generally 80%. You can optionally run the battery health test to compare your battery's energy retention to when it was new. This would be an amazing, it's really brave of Tesla to actually release this test. It would be really interesting if other companies did it as well. I bet some of them would be really scared to do it. So as you can see, it could take up to ages and the test valid for the next 6 months. And they don't actually allow you to run a new test until that's expired because it would be quite stressful on the battery. So let's have a go, battery health. So the vehicle's in park, battery's on 20% or less. We're on 46 miles, so we're on 15%. I know a lot of people have run it all the way down, but this is what we've got home with, so screw it, we're gonna go with this. Vehicle's connected to the internet, got the Wi-Fi booster in the garage. No, so vehicle's connected to an AC charger, so we'll do that in a second. And AC charger could provide at least, so it can do that. So we'll go back to the charging, open the charge port. Ugh. Little, it's cocked its leg. Get the cable, plug her in. Let's just make sure, because there is like a cool down period on this charger. So yeah, push to charge now. Okay, so now it's waiting for the EV. It's like a 10 minute cool down when you plug it in. So let's go back here. Service, battery health, battery test. Ah, there you go, good. I was thinking it charges at over 7, but it was just taking a second to read it. So we're good to go. So your vehicle must remain connected to AC charging for not up to 19 hours. Obviously you get the notifications through the app when it's done. During the test, your vehicle's battery will discharge to 0 to 10% before recharging all the way up. Noise and heat generation may occur. I might try and get that later on if it's making an absolute racket just to see how loud it actually is. But this is normal, not concern. Avoid interacting with your car or the app during the test. You can cancel the test at any time. Start test. Woo! Okay, so it's gone really quiet. It's turned all the aircon off. 19 hours remaining. Battery level. Vehicle's battery to discharge. Noise and heat. Do not leave occupants unattended. Ensure charger remains connected and avoid interacting with the vehicle or Tesla app. I'll cancel. Right, we'll get out. Leave it to it. And I'll check back with you later on. Right, I've literally just jumped out of the car, and yeah, the noise. Listen to that. So you've got the mic on, so that is quite loud. If it keeps doing that for the next 12 to 19 hours, I'm not sure how happy the neighbors are gonna be about it. But yeah, that's pretty loud. Right, we'll come back at the end with the test results. I think with these kind of things, they say that the EVs, they'll lose a lot of degradation in the first kind of year to 2 years, first 10 to 15,000 miles. So this is the first test I've done on it. So it's gonna be really interesting to see what the degradation is. And let's see if I'm gonna be embarrassed or not. And hopefully the Tesla, I'm really hoping for over 90% still. And we'll go from there. Right, see you in a bit. Okay, so I know it said don't fiddle with the app, but I can't resist because we're doing a test. So yeah, it's just giving exactly the same information there. And it's given me the percentage of and how long's left, so 18 hours remaining. And you can cancel it from there. The rest of the app is all usable as normal. No, it's not actually, so you can't scroll down far enough. So yeah, I'm gonna get out of here now and leave it to it. Ciao. Okie dokie, quick update. We're nearly an hour in. In the future, if I was gonna do this again, I'd definitely recommend draining the battery a lot more first because it's still draining. It's got 15 miles, 5%, so it's nearly down, then it can start refilling. I know some of the other tests I've seen, people have drained it right down to like 2 or 3%, which I think would make a lot of sense. Obviously, at the end, I don't think I've actually proven that the car's done 20,000 miles yet either. I can't scroll all the way down here. It's not letting me. But I'll show that in the car when we see the results. Okay, it's 8 o'clock. So it's been going for an hour and a half. And it actually says battery resting. Still says 17 hours left. 8 miles is only 3%. I'm not sure if it started to recharge yet. When it does, it'll take about 10 hours to fully recharge because it should go up to 100% unless I stop it, which obviously I'm not going to. Yeah, so we'll keep an eye on it, give it a few hours, go to sleep, and then see when the app says that it's finished. Okay, quick update. So it is charging the battery now, so 10 hours remaining because it's 7.5 kilowatts an hour, 75 kilowatt battery, it'll take about 10 hours. So it's up to just over 10% now, 36 miles. So it's probably been charging for 45 minutes or so. Right, let's see how it does through the night.
Right, I woke up in the night for a wee. So I thought I'd have a check and it's on course, 4 hours left, ready for about 8 o'clock in the morning. So it looks like it's gonna take about 11 and a half hours total. It's up to 223. 75%, so not too much longer left now. As you might know though, from think about it like a car park, the batteries, they'll fill up really fast to start off with, and then when it gets fuller and fuller and fuller, it takes a little bit longer. If you use that kind of theory, it explains charging an EV quite well. Right, have a quick wee, back to bed, and we'll finish it off at about 8 o'clock. Cheers. Okay, so we've woken up. It says there, battery health test complete, view results in the service menu or the Tesla app. So I'm not going to click on here. We'll do it in the car in a moment. So I know, so it's taken 13 hours. I know in the night when I had a look, obviously the maths was a little bit out because I was obviously a bit tired. I said it was taking about 11 and a half. But yeah, so 13 hours total and we'll go check out the results.
All right, the folks, we're here. The battery test is complete. Says on here, charging completed. And supposedly on there, it gave 79.74 kilowatts. I don't think it gave quite that much because the battery's only got 78 and usable is 75. So let's jump in and have a little look, see what the screen says. Ooh, nice. So battery health, 97% of your battery health is healthy. Energy retention is within the expected range. And let's have a look. So up here it's given 295, so at 100%, so it's maybe recalibrated the numbers ever so slightly. It used to say 297 on 100%, but of course that could be down to driving style as well. So here's the numbers. There's your 20,000 miles. And I did check on the app because the supercharging affects the battery health because it is quite aggressive with how fast it is. We've done 5% of those miles. Supercharging, so maybe fractionally over 1,000 miles, so that's probably why the battery's in such good condition. But considering the battery degrades the most in its first couple of years, I'm really happy with that, 97%. So let's go back to the service now and see what it says. Service down, battery health, so I don't have the option to run another test. It just gives me that my health, that the battery is healthy. Excellent, brilliant news. Right, so hopefully that is a UK first
says the Model 3 Performance 2024 that has had a 20,000 mile battery health check. So bring on the next 10,000 and let's see how this carries on degrading, I suppose, slowly, or hopefully not. Right, cheerio, guys. Bye.